Hello guys, Silver Butterflies here. I just unpacked a box of a perfume which is I know for ages since it's created, but for some reason I didn't bought it. But recently, before the events, you know which events, I decided to buy a few more perfumes so I can talk about, because you wouldn't be able to go out of doors and you still have a urge to buy something. So I had to urge to buy something in a budget price, so I bought this. Christina Aguilera, by Christina Aguilera. I like the bottle itself, the packaging. It's lace, sexuality, and I saw this clip with Christina Aguilera. First one is she's all these golden locks, putting some perfume. It says something like, sometimes only this you have to put it on yourself. And another video is about commercial, how they created that video. So it's here 75 milliliters, and it's more than enough for the whole summer, for instance. I'm doing this video in end of March. I don't know when I'm gonna publish it. Maybe very soon, maybe I don't know, we'll see. We have plenty of time right now sitting at home, aren't we? First thing I felt is rose and vanilla background. Unfortunately, neither rose, but vanilla was there in the base, but the rose wasn't there. I mixed it for the peonies. It declared a lot of other notes. I couldn't recognize them for some reason. Maybe eventually I will start liking it, maybe not. First impression was in my Russian video to give advice to someone who look for very unpretentious, very politically correct, very soft, not annoying perfume for the office. And here, the top notes of blackcurrant, I don't feel it, pineapple, exotic fruits, tangerine. No, first thing I felt peony, which is on the middle note, and plum. There's plum and another flower, jasmine. I don't know, for now I don't feel it, maybe in future. It's not that distinct, it's very, very vague. It's almost way not to recognize. And the base notes are vanilla, musk, and white musk, actually, and amber. This is a traditional combination for the base. What I like about Aguilera perfumes, they're in the same shape, kind of thing, most of them, and in the same style. The only thing, the type of lace are different. Some of them are way black, some of them red, some of them golden. And here in Toronto, I never saw nothing except for this version. For so many years, I keep passing by this perfume, and eventually I decided to buy it, just to buy it for the hell of it. So I bought it, and I'm not even regretting, because the price was right. The moment I bought it was also right, because I have to find something new in summer, and I bought a few more for future tents to review, so stay tuned. My average estimate for this perfume, maybe 3 out of 5, maybe 3 minus. It's I'm doing it Russian scale. It's like 5 the top note, or sorry, 5 the top mark in school, and 0 is 0, so. Another fragrance of famous singer, which is Time Wears Her Name. So this is femininity of Marilyn Monroe. She was that in those golden locks. What I love to have in my collection, this Glam in a golden bottle, Glam X. I tell you all what they have here. 2007, which is that. Then it goes 2009, Christina Aguilera By Night. This one I also would love to try, with the black top, the lace here more darker. Then it goes Definition, Glam X, Eau de Parfum. That's what I want to try. 2017, never even seen it. I saw it in Europe, but I didn't bought it because my sister was bugging me not to buy so many perfumes. Now I regret, of course, and God knows when I go. Inspire. Then it goes the Red Sin. I would love to. Red Sin is my Royal Desire, Secret Potion, Touch of Seduction, Unforgettable, Violet Noir, 2018. I would love to have that one just for the bottle. It's a dark purple-ish bottle with a lace underneath with a more white lace. A woman. Exposed Desire. Exposed Glamour. Exposed Passion. Exposed Stardust. Stardust is interesting. And Experience. 2019. Never even heard of that. I'm following these perfumes on Fragrantica. But they never done any article about that one, and I never saw it in stores, obviously. So this is my little review for Christina Aguilera. One thing I can say, I love to listen to Christina Aguilera. And what about you? You tell me your preferences. You tell if anyone has it. Do you like it? Maybe you don't like it. Tell me all. It will be very interesting to hear from you. Bye for now. I'm your silver butterfly. All the best.